What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Evil West. So, in the last episode, we moved through a whole forest filled with these giant leech thingies, and now we are standing in the mouth of a huge dead monster. And we are about to jump into its mouth. And my best guess is something's gonna attack us.
A trip into its guts. Great.
Oh yeah, there we go. Bring it, you bastards. Wow, okay. A lot of those guys. I'll take that. Good night. Anyone else left? Nope. Alright, cool. Let's move on then. Yeah.
Christ, what a stink.
This is pretty freaking disgusting. Oh, what now? Wow, that's big. Wow. Ouch. Ouch. Wow, it's fast. Attacks three times. Vomits. Whoa, okay. Apparently not. Thought I just had to figure it out there. Okay, that works. Thank you. Okay. Just you and me, big guy. Try that again. Okay, okay. Does absolutely nothing. This is stressful. Just me. It's not really giving me a clear pattern here. It's like three individuals. Chill out, big guy. That worked. Ouch. Okay. Okay, so I can just look on the ground and try to stay away. Yeah, of course you bring those fuckers up again. Okay, this is getting pretty crazy. Thank you. full-on mayhem. Jesus. Stay alive, stay alive. Horrible commentary, and I do apologize for that, but this is freaking stressful. Why am I not running? Okay, let's try this again. This is freaking brutal. Come on. come on. Keep looking down. This is intense. I'm zoomed in like this. This is pretty annoying. There we go. Nope, still can't see anything. I have to see. Fuck off. Is there anything? Okay. This is so weird. Okay. Why? Why does he stop sprinting? That's annoying as fuck. Jesus. Chill the fuck out, dude. Okay, okay. Come on. One down. Down with you guys. Can kill that thing. Whew, it looks like it. Damn. Fuck that guy. That was freaking mental.
So this is where those beasts get their magical blood from. Once that ancient fella in Baxter was sucked dry, she found you, huh? Christ, I'm starting to hate mythology.
Right, back to Calico. Cash, we'll take it. Anything new in the kitchen? Not really. Okay, let's check out upstairs, see if there's anything new. Not safe. Okay. Yep. Don't fall and hurt yourself. Nope. Nothing here. Alright. Downstairs we go then. Catchy little tune. Okay. No new collectibles here. Okay.
Oh, there you are, Mr. Renty. Dr. Blackwell is waiting for you in the suite.
Thank you. I'll just take this first. Anything else we can pick up? No, doesn't look like it. Oh, yep, yeah, there we go. Okay. What about Peter? Yes, please. Emilia's curriculum. Emilia F. Blackwell, born 1861, received her medical degree from the Women's Medical College of Pennsylvania in 1879. She was 18. Pretty impressive. Member of the RI since 1881, assigned to Calico in 1883. Her medical degree combined with her expertise in botany guaranteed her a post at the manor. Soon she joined a team investigating the medicinal properties of specific plants. La Orchid de la Vida, found near Lake Maurepas, was researched as a possible antidote. Eric Brooks, the leader of the research effort, asked William Rentier to reassign Emilia to Calico as she wasn't much of a team player and worked better off on her own. Neat.
With that technology, we could have freed the Great Plains.
Pretty impressive to get a medical degree at 18. That's young. I mean, as far as I know, it takes like 8 years to become like a GP.
To be honest, I'm skeptical. You really think that's what Felicity was hiding in McCallum's?
I wouldn't bet on it, but I wouldn't bet against it either.
Okay. Let's see what they have to say.
Anybody ever heard of a colossal monster with a forest growing on its back? Because I got some samples.
Mine.
That's a Mi'kmaq. In Huron Indian folklore, it's some kind of minor deity.
It was covered head to toe in those damn leeches.
That means we found yet another blood factory set up by Debano and Felicity.
That would explain why they attacked Baxter. They were protecting their source, the ancient blood they used to transform their familiars.
Bad news is this Mi'kmaq thing was supplying their war for quite some time now, allowing those foul bloods to spread all over the country. The good news is they won't do it anymore.
Okay, let's go see how our father's doing.
Mr. Rentigan, it's about your father. Hurry!
Yeah, I'm trying to hurry.
Mr. Jesse! Help!
I'm coming.
I've heard shouts, sir. What's going on in there?
Stand down, Davis.
Nope. That is definitely off his meds, infected with something. Hey,
step aside.
Put that down.
Even if he doesn't kill us in our sleep, that link in his head will lead the ticks right to us.
Then let them come. Killing ticks is what the Rentier Institute does.
You listen to yourself? This isn't about your birthright. This is what happens when we run a government agency like a goddamn monarchy. All our protocols go out the window as soon as Daddy Dearest.
Keep talking to me about the rules, you bureaucratic shrew.
Please, we're all on the same team, remember?
Only when it suits him. How about finally telling me where Edgar went?
He's in Maurepas. Searching for the plant to make the regen compound.
The regen compound? Now you're wasting what little resources we have left chasing a fairy tale?
Listen, Mr. Gravener's an experienced agent. If he didn't have faith in his mission, he wouldn't bother. We are at war, Doctor. Who else is worth saving if not the leader of the Institute? And in the long run, it could help everybody if the thing by some miracle actually works.
You have until tomorrow morning. In the meantime, your father will be restrained and placed under round-the-clock supervision.
Fine. I'm gonna get Edgar's ass out of those swamps. And if I get back with that plant and I still see that shotgun in your hand, you better damn well prove you know how to use it.
You picked a strange time to assert yourself, Virgil. Why'd you back Jesse's quest for this ridiculous compound?
Just because the scientists at the manor didn't find anything, doesn't mean there isn't something there. I mean, did they ever let you take a look?
No.
We have a habit at Calico of making the impossible happen, Doctor. I fixed Mr. Jesse's gauntlet, made it better even. Scott found the best lead we have with those leeches. If anyone can make that compound work, it's you.
Right, now we are in a luminous swamp. Find Edgar Grip. Yeah, that is gonna have to wait, because I am going to take a break here, guys. But when we come back, we're gonna move through this creepy glowing swamp thingy and hopefully find Edgar and whatever plant he was looking for. So that's all for now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and be sure to stay tuned for the next one. Until then, take care. Bye.